everyone, I'm Amanda and welcome back or welcome to my channel. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to crochet this little baby headband. This crochet baby headband is part of a little set, so there's a matching baby bonnet. Some matching baby booties. A matching baby dress. And there's a matching baby blanket as well. All of these items come with separate video tutorials and they come with free written patterns as well. I'll link all of the tutorials and free patterns for these other items below the video in the description box. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. There are also subtitles on all of my tutorials. Just click on the little gear icon at the bottom of the video, select subtitles, and then select the language of your preference. This baby headband is a really quick and easy design. You'll need a light worsted double knit yarn. I used Surdar Snuggly Soothing, but you can use any category 3 double knitting yarn. To make size 0 to 6 months, you'll need a G 4mm crochet hook, and to make size 6 to 12 months, you'll need a size 7, which is a 4.5mm hook. You'll also need a pair of scissors and a tapestry needle for weaving in your ends. Please find more information and links to all the materials I used below the video in the description box. And you can also find a link to the free written pattern below the video as well. Before we begin, remember that this tutorial, like all my other videos, has been divided up into chapters. If you would like to jump to a particular section of the video, then please click on the relevant timestamp. You'll find all this information in the description box below the video. To begin, make a chain of 3. So there's 1, 2, and 3. And then I'm going to begin working in the first chain here. And I'm going to work 1 half double crochet. And then a chain 2, and then I'm going to slip stitch back into that first chain, and then I'm going to chain 2, 1 and 2, and then back into that first chain I'm going to work 1 half double crochet. Then chain 2, 1 and 2, and then slip stitch back into that chain, and then I'll do that one more time, chain 2, 1 and 2, and then work 1 half double crochet into the same chain. And then chain 2, 1 and 2, and then I'm going to slip stitch back into the same chain. And that's our little flower. at the end of our first tie. So to continue with the tie, we're going to make a chain of 42. And I'm just going to grab this little yarn tail here. And I'm going to begin my chain with the working yarn and my yarn tail. So make a chain of 42. So there's 1, 2, 3, and then I'm just going to drop the yarn tail and continue working with my working yarn. So there's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 42. And then we're ready to begin on row number 1. So for this row, I'm going to work into the fourth chain from the hook. So counting 1, 2, 3, and 4 into that fourth chain. And I'm just going to turn it around so we can work into the back bump. Into that back bump, I'm going to work 1 double crochet. Chain 2, and then back into the same chain, I'm going to work 2 double crochet. So there's 1, and then another double crochet back into that same chain. And then for row 2, chain 1 and then turn your work, and then I'm going to come over to the chain 2 space here, and into that chain 2 space I'm going to slip stitch. And then I'm going to chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. And then back into the chain 2 space, I'm going to work 1 double crochet. Chain 2, 1 and 2. And then back into the chain 2 space, I'm going to work 2 double crochet. So there's 1, and then another double crochet back into the same space. So there's row 1, row 2. And then for the remainder of the main part of the headband, you're going to repeat row number 2. And you'll repeat row number 2 until you have a total of 24 rows. So I'll just show you again. The row that you're going to be repeating, you'll chain 1, turn your work, then you'll come to the chain 2 space and work a slip stitch. Then chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and then work 1 double crochet back into the chain 2 space, chain 2, 1 and 2, and then back into that chain 2 space, work 2 double crochet. So there's 1, and then another double crochet. So repeat this row until you have a total of 24 rows, and then we'll work the second tie together. Once you've worked your 24 rows, we'll then make our second tie. So to do this, chain 1, turn your work, and then slip stitch into the chain two space. And then from here, we're ready to work on our second tie. And it's exactly the same as the first tie. So we'll make a chain of 42. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 42. And then we'll make our little decorative flower, just like we did with the first tie. So starting in the fourth chain from the hook, 1, 2, 3, and 4, into that back bump, we'll work one half double crochet. Chain two, and then we'll slip stitch back into the same chain. And then we'll chain two, 1 and 2, and then we'll work one half double crochet back into the same chain. Chain two, and then we'll slip stitch into the bottom of that chain. And then we'll repeat that, chain two, one half double crochet into the same chain. Chain two, 1 and 2, and then we'll slip stitch back into the same chain. And then I'm just going to fasten off. So grab your scissors and cut your yarn. And then chain one, pull the yarn through. And then I'm just going to weave this little yarn tail into my little flower, just to hide it and secure it. And then if we just come back down to the first tie that I made, I'm just going to, this is the first flower that we made on the first tie. I'm just going to clip my little yarn tail here. I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you liked it, please consider giving it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little notification bell so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. Thanks so much for watching.